Eric, humanitarian efforts underway around the world to help Ukraine and Ukrainians living in Ukraine. After Russia's invasion about a month ago, it's an unprecedented moment. You're of Ukrainian descent. Give us an idea of how you wanted to help and how you decided to help.
Yeah, so we're in a unique situation. Our family is in Lviv, all the way on the west side, next to the Poland border. We have an office there of 38 employees that we over time build up. But it's been a lot safer there than the eastern part of the country. So our family, as of yesterday, good news, they were able to go to the embassy in Varsovia or Warsaw, and they were able to get their fingerprints, so they'll be able to fly back to Canada. So in my case, my cousin and her daughter are coming to my house, and my aunt will be moving into my dad's place. But our cousin and the husband of my cousin are both staying in Lviv. But the situation has been good there. And even our employees, our 40 employees, 30 of them left Poland, a lot of them went to Portugal. But the 10 people remaining in Lviv are doctors during the day, and they do some, they work for us in our transport division at night. So it still is a bit of not a normal life, but I think it is much safer there than the rest of the country.
Give us an idea of this initiative by Quebec businesses.
Yeah, so in our case, we have a lot of our employees wanted to come back to Canada. The visa system was very complicated. We work hard with all the federal side, with Minister Joly, Minister Rodriguez, Minister Champagne, Minister Fraser, and in Quebec, Minister Boulay. And finally, on Thursday, they've agreed for a 3-year temporary visa. That means everybody's allowed to come in. They're allowed to work for a Canadian company. In the case of Montreal, they're allowed to work in Quebec without the French language. If they bring their family, their kids will be going to French schools, but they can integrate the school system. So now since Thursday, that's why I spoke to about 12 colleagues of mine and quickly 18 companies, Bombardier, National Bank, CIM, all of the, I would say the Quebecing got together. And our goal is to bring 1,000 employees and their families, but our goal is to get workers and take care of them just like when we already hire a lot of people from Western Europe, from the US, from Mexico. So just to have a focus on Ukrainian workers instead of France or Spain. So I think it was very well received. And the good news is we were 18 this morning, and I think our list by the end of the day will be more than 50 companies. So the goal again is to create the link between the number of people in Ukraine looking for work. There's already 10,000 Ukrainian immigrants that already arrived in Canada. So working with the federal government, with different portal to do that link and to put a focus on really getting access to Ukrainian employees and their families.
Eric, you had mentioned at the start 18 companies and growing to 50 companies now. Ultimately, where do you see the trajectory of this going? How do you see it growing and expanding?
So the first step was to educate people that it is possible in the companies. And now is to work together that we can share best practice and also work with the government portal on which immigrants are coming across Canada. And hopefully that other companies, this was a Quebec-based, I guess, pilot project, but I don't see any reason why the rest of Canada doesn't put a focus. So it's really putting a focus on Ukrainian workers for the next few months. And instead of putting a focus on getting 5 Americans coming to Canada to help us on a movie or IT. So I think if we can create that across Canada, that would be great news.
Give us an idea of why companies are getting behind this and showing their support for Ukraine.
Well, at the start, our initial goal when we started this project and we were talking to the government was 10 companies and 100 families each. And then in a matter of just a few word of mouth, we're already 18 companies. So we'll see the numbers. But the goal is, I think the first goal was to to sensibilize and Canadian companies, in this case, we focus very locally in Montreal and on Quebec, that you are able to hire workers from Ukraine. There is visas in place. They're very sophisticated. They speak English. They have good knowledge. So it's not like you're hiring somebody that doesn't speak English or the language, which is a lot more difficult. So I think most of them were just didn't have the knowledge. And once they saw this, so now we got to work as creative, like we say in French, like guichet unique. We have to work a portal to get everybody together, and working hard also with the federal and provincial government to get the links between the companies and the workers, the employees.
Eric, you mentioned working with different levels of government and ultimately getting that portal up and running. Give us an idea of some of the obstacles you've encountered to get this off the ground.
Oh, as you know, Quebec is a unique province. We have two immigration ministers. We need both the provincial and the federal to agree. So I just wanted, that's why we work really with Quebec companies, and that was done. I must say everybody's working hard. The timing, I think, was the private sector always wants the government to go faster. But I think, I did say thank you to the different ministers. They work hard to make this possible and happen. I think now we're at a position now that we have to execute the project and make sure we connect everybody. And every HR department of these companies, as you can imagine, these are billion-dollar companies. They have a very strong HR department. We'll work together, share best practice of what they're doing to attract those Ukrainian immigrants. So it's going to be real, and it's really a private base. Nobody's getting subsidies, nobody's getting help, nobody's getting financing. Everybody that we hire or family will be taken care of by each company.
How can companies get involved? How can people get involved? Who would you like to see get involved in this?
Yeah, the most important, it's really a project with companies that can hire between 40 to 80 employees and their family if needed. Again, if somebody is a single lady of 30 years old and she has no family, she's also welcome. You don't need to have a family of four. So it's just, if you're that size of company, very happy. We have a group that puts you in contact with different government people. We share HR best practice. We're going to be creating a portal. So just you write to the Stingray people. And over the next few weeks, we're already starting having some people coming in next week, and we'll be able to grow this bigger. But it's very decentralized. This is not every company, we just help them best practice. The government is helping us with different portals. The federal government has a great portal for Ukrainian immigrants. So it's to do a link, a bit like just like an Indeed or a Monster, the monster.com website. So we're trying to put everybody together, and each company can go at their pace and who they need.